Definitely the pink bicycle that my mom gifted me. Lily got me a friendship bracelet. Strange letters with sketchy symbols on them. Brad and I had our third date today. I received a strange email today.
We'll be soon in touch with you.
These emails and letters are affecting my mental health. It's like someone is paving down a path to lure me in right outside my doorstep. And it's almost like they, assuming there is someone and it's not in my head, won't stop until I reply. My mom thinks I'm stressed about school. Honestly, I could never argue with her. She had a chat with the school counselor and they have suggested a few sessions. It's so annoying. Now I'll have to waste an hour after classes every other day. Mr. Davis, I believe, is the reincarnation of a dull sloth. I can't stand him. I told Betty about this. She laughed about it for a whole minute, but then she gave me her hoodie to make me feel better. P.S. I have to admit that the hoodie does help.
Hey, it's the Riverstone Car Wash again. We are glad to see that you reached the end of the vault. Ding ding ding, it's time for a riddle. I dance with the wind, a flickering desire, in the darkest of nights, I light up like a pyre. I devour all I touch, not an ancient myth, a wild, untamed force,
that you do not play with. There is no room for mistakes. One step in the wrong direction and...
The last person has joined. Let's start.
I suppose we can start, whatever this is. I don't have much time. You'll be led easily, Travis. It's not safe.
You need to chill. What is this exactly?
Four of you solved the vault and found the key. Now, we can begin.
Yes. All this sounds crazy.
Keep quiet and listen. I've been waiting for too long.
Don't you dare talk to me like that, you asshole.
There is only one rule. Indiscipline will not be tolerated. You all have a very simple task to follow. Your task is to ascertain and disclose the name and profession of the given target. The first participant whose personal information is revealed will be promptly eliminated from this call. You should be able to see your targets under your name.
We're all up against each other?
Not my first time. Gotcha. What? It will be sad to see you go.
One of the targets has been exposed and will be eliminated.
No! No! This can't be!
You can't do this!
What?
This is the end of this call. You'll be contacted soon.
Fall is here. It's so beautiful all around. The weather is cool, and the sunlight falling under the trees looks golden. I wish I could spend the rest of this weather basking in the sun before it disappears in the cold. This morning was incredible. Kevin and I decided to skip class and walk in the forest on a whim. But things took a turn when Brad showed up. He was fuming with jealousy. Brad has never been fond of Kevin, and their ongoing disagreements are a source of frustration for me. I have always wished they could get along. Brad usually isn't the insecure type, but around Kevin, I don't recognize him.
Hello, you've reached Amanda Lane. I am unable to take your call right now, but your message is important to me. Please leave a message.
Thank you for calling PhoneFinder.com. Please note that tracking any number outside your contacts list is prohibited. Please enter the phone number to get your unique tracking code. Thank you. Your tracking code is 4136. Thank you for calling PhoneFinder.com.
Thank you. Davis here. Who's this? Wait, I'm going outside. Hey, I'm sorry, but I told you I can't help even if I wanted to. Why are you calling me then? I made it clear that I can't help you. If you don't stop bothering me, I will not hesitate to call the police. Wait, why am I even talking to you? I'm gonna hang up. What now? I've got work to do, and I'm sure you must be a busy man as well. Teenagers do tend to act out sometimes. I hope it's nothing serious, but what the police said. A runaway. We are done here. I told you I cannot help you.
Thank you.
Mr. Davis told me I should journal. It helps with untangling one's thought process. Little does he know, I love penning my thoughts down. The good part about today is that it's Brad's birthday, and I can't wait for him to see what I got for his special day. Here's an update. I think I gave too much of myself to people around me who didn't care about me at all. Yes, I'm talking about Brad. I got him a pendant with our initials on it. It cost me my savings. It was supposed to be this romantic keepsake. But I realized I did all this for nothing. He's the most ungrateful person on the planet. He had a look at it and tossed it behind the couch. I was hurt. I wonder if all relationships go through this, or if I am in the wrong one.
Hey, I just saw the missed calls. I'm sorry. My phone died last night, and the weather was terrible, so I stayed at a motel in Hayburg. It's not like I wanted to stay away. I had no other choice. You didn't even ask if I was okay. The first thing I did this morning was to call you. I left you a couple of texts yesterday morning, but you never replied. You never called me back. Don't you dare say that. Don't you dare try to be the greater person, sacrificing everything for your family, because you are not. You just care about yourself, your agency, your cases, and I don't see myself in it anymore. I'm home. I want you to come back home tonight. We need to talk. Trying won't save us forever. It's always your fallback, and someday there might be nothing left. I need to check on Jim. We'll talk later. Don't expect this to be easy.
Okay, I'm doing this. I can't live in fear anymore. I need to do something about it. It's enough. I need to face whatever is there on the other side of the door. I don't have a good feeling about it. I mean, what can go wrong, right? Whoever is behind all this, I'm going to find them. There must be a reason that they are after me. I can't let Mom or Dad know about it. I can't let anyone know about it because I know they'll try to stop me. But I need someone on my side just in case things go south. Maybe this is crazy. What am I even doing?
Adam? Can you hear me? I'm looking around. I don't see anything. I need to focus. It's getting dark already. This is not going to be easy. There is a trail in front of me. I feel I should continue here. I think I need to climb down this trail. My eyes are taking time to adjust to the dark. I'm looking around. Wait! What? What? Wait. I think I see a cave. This doesn't make any sense. Hey, Adam? Are you with me on this? It's getting creepier by the minute. We're losing time. I'm doing this for her. I can barely see anything. All right. I'll just stick left and follow the wall. I've got this. Damn it! It's nothing, I'm fine. I've had worse. I forgot I have a flashlight on me. It's pitch black and this silence isn't helping. It's a labyrinth! I'm gonna trust my gut here. Okay, there are two paths in front of me. There's the sound of water on the left, but complete silence on the right. It's unsettling. Guess we'll see what's up with the silence. Great, a dead end, classic! Oh, wait. There's something on the wall. A white and black rose. What could this mean? Someone's been here. I'm gonna explore the other side. All right, I'm heading back down the path. Wait. No, not now. No, please, not right now. Damn it! Great, my flashlight's dead. I'm practically blind here. What should I do now? I can't turn back now, Adam. I've come too far to give up. All right, moving ahead. I think I've hit another dead end. It wasn't a dead end. There was a slide leading to an underpassage. I fell. Great, my phone screen is cracked too. Just what I needed. I need to keep going. I think I'm seeing something. Let me get closer to it. Am I seeing things or... Is something really there? Hey, Adam, I think I found something. Check this out. Does it make any sense to you? I'm gonna keep moving. I'm in too deep in this cave. I hope I don't lose signal. Adam, do you hear that? I think someone's here. I can't see. Oh, wait. I think I found a crack in the wall. Some sort of a fissure. I'm not sure, but I can hide in here. I just have to squeeze myself into it. They should have been able to see me in here. I'm not feeling good, Adam. It's not... I'm claustrophobic. I can't breathe properly in here. I think they're right here. I think they're right here. Okay, I'm not holding onto my shirt now. I see my hands. I see the wall in front of me. I see my phone. I hear my breathing. I hear my heartbeat. I hear your voice. I can't really move, but I can move my fingers. I'm blinking. My eyes. Do my lungs count? I think they're gone now. Yeah, I think I'm all right now. Thanks for helping me, Adam. Really, thank you. I need to keep moving. I think there is a door in front of me. It feels like one. Oh, wait. I can feel some kind of... I can feel some sort of lock on here. How can I open it? How do I open it? There must be something... The wall. There's something on it. I need your help with this, Adam. Got it. Let's see if this works. It's working. The oxygen's hitting me. Adam, I know you don't want to hear this, but there's a house. There's a house at a distance. I'm gonna go check it out. This house. I've never seen anything like it. It has... Yeah! But how do you know that? I think I'm gonna go over and see for myself. Wait, I can hear someone inside. I've reached the door. Damn, it's locked. I need to find another way in. Yeah. Yes. I think I found a back door. I think I can open it. It's not locked. I'm in. Wait. I'm sure I heard someone inside. There's no one here. Seems we're in luck for now. I'll look for any clues or anything out of the blue. Yeah. Only one. It's you. You received that, didn't you? Who is this Adam? Why do they know so much about Zoe? Why are you working with them? Trust you? Trust you? All I have done so far is trust you. And it looks like I've made a mistake. Damn it! Crap! Someone's at the door, I've got to run! I think I've lost them. What the hell was that? Someone's after me!
What's your emergency?